it's enough for you to start. If you know the sound of the letter and these three movements, that's it, you're done. All you have to know right now that there is a long vowel. The long vowel is twice as much as emphatic sound or gemination on the short vowel, like ba, ba, bi, bi, bu, bu. And there is a letter, okay, correspond with this long vowel. The long vowel for ba is alif, the long vowel for bi is the ya, the long vowel for bu is the waw. So right now, if you know the letter, the sound of the letter, you know them in three short vowel and three long vowel, you will start reading. You'll face a little problem with the position of the letter. Each letter has like three or four positions. Let's say four positions. Freestanding position, the ba by itself, I don't have a whiteboard. Then the ba in the beginning of the word, that's the initial position. Then the ba in the middle of the word, that's the middle position. Then the ba at the end of the word, that's the final position. The problem here, it's a little problem, it's not that big. The little problem over here that the ba and the three position varies in writing. Varies in writing. So you have a three shape of the ba. One in the initial, one in the middle, one at the end. So this applies to every letter. That's why in each lesson, try to learn not more than two or three letters. Because it takes a lot of time to remember where I put how and how the ba it looks in the middle, because there is similarity between the ba and the ya and the na. These letters, the in the middle, they will be like a tooth. In that tooth, how do you know the ba from the na? Is by looking at the dot. Where is the dot? At the top or at the bottom? If it's at the top, it's na. If it's at the bottom, it's ba. This is the hardest thing in the Arabic language. Other than that, it's not hard. It's easier than English. Why it's easier than English? In English, you have to learn word by word. I'll give you an example. The H, when you see home, you utter the H over here. The H affects how you say home. But in our, the H is silent. Like if you want to make the pattern of make it plural. Book, make it plural, we say you add S, it will become books. Now dog, add S to it and become Z. So this is something you have to learn each word by itself. That's why I think nobody has a spelling bee but the English people. No one. It's shame on you if you ask the French one how you spell this one. Or Bil Arabi, nobody will ask how you spell your name. There is no spelling. You have to know. So in English, no, everyone, how you spell your name, how you spell that word. Spelling is very hard because sometimes, like eight and eight. Eight over here, like the number eight, it takes five letters, and another eight, A-T-E, it's a three letter. You have to know it from the context of the phrase. So it's hard, really. The English language is harder than Arabic. In Arabic, the sound you hear, that's the sound you write. So there is no problem in the dictation. Do you want me to continue? I could continue on and on, but if there is any question right now, I would like to answer. Yes?
I have two questions. How is modern standard Arabic different from classical Arabic? And then the second question is, you're saying it's an easy language, but what about the grammar?
That's very good question. How is modern standard Arabic different? I think it stands to reason that language as an entity undergo so many circumstances of change. Language could develop, could die, could rebirth, could expand, and this is applied on the Arabic. So the classical Arabic was the dominant until the 19th century. But after Napoleon came and attacked Egypt, and after that, the contact with the West started. So we have a lot of medical terms, and Lara translation. So many things the Arabic start to acquire, okay? And so many things the Arabic language start to drop. Arabic language is 12 million words. The English language is 600,000. The French language is 300,000. The Russian language is 130,000. Arabic language is 12 million words. Why? Because we have Lara synonym. And for the sword, you have 1,000 maybe words. For the lion, you have the same. For the faras, you have the same. So during the 19th century, we have a language which developed from the contact with the West. The language that we develop from the contact with the West, it become different from the classical Arabic. Even the classical Arabic is not pure 100%. The Quran has a Greek word, like sirata. Sirata is sistrata from the Greek, okay? We have a Persian word in the Quran. But in the 19th century, we have Lara word. The Arabic language gave its word to Spanish like 15%. Besides, the West affects us not only by bringing a new word, like Qaraba, that's an Arabic, we coined that word, Qaraba, because we don't know the Qaraba. When they created, we coined that word. But the West affected us not by introducing this word, even by the structure of our phrase. Like, give you an example, like male practice or male nutrition. This one, we translate the whole thing, سوء التغذية. This one never happened before. The re, repeat or reintroduce or whatever. The re, also we adopted. I'adat al-i'tibar. I'adat kada wa kada. I'adat kada wa kada. So we took from the West so many things to our land. What we took, which is amazing and nobody knows about it, that we took the comma, the poem, that's in my column. Because before that, there is no dot, there is no comma, there is no nothing. You need a special person who knows about manuscript to read. This one introduced about 200 years ago. Otherwise, nobody can read. Nobody can read. So figure out how our interaction with the West did help. That's how we create the modern standard Arabic. Now, if you have, I have a book of Ahmed Fares Shudyan called As-Saq al-As-Saq. And I read like 2 pages of that book, like 80% of the word I did not understand. 80%. I could show it to you. So figure out, when I say 12 million words, that means so many of these words are dropped now or dead. Did I answer yours?
That was the first question. What about Arabic grammar?
Oh, Arabic grammar, that's perfect. Well, the Arabic language is known by its conservatism. We kept the grammar. The grammar we kept. For some reason, the grammar kept. We still have the grammar. First of all, the purists are the people who are fanatic about language. They are against any change. They kept the grammar. First of all, the Quran is considered the reference for the Arabic language. If you have any problem with the language, you go back to the Quran. And the Prophet said, if the Quran doesn't solve the answer, go to the poetry. He admit that poetry could be also a reference for the language. So the grammar stayed the same grammar. But right now, there is a movement that is very important. The short vowel I talked to you about, they have a grammatical they denote some grammatical issues. If you have dhamma at the end, it's subject. If you have fatha at the end, it's object. If you have kasra at the end, I mean, it's preceded by prepositions in these things. So these, they serve for grammatical function. So there is no change to the grammar. Until now, there is no change to the grammar. There is a movement, but I don't think we'll succeed. Why? Because the Quran, for so many of us, there's about 1 billion and 200 million, they consider the Arabic language is the word, the Quran is the word of God. So we will not have any change, I think. We will not have any change. Even these million, billion, and 200, they read, they don't understand that much, maybe, but they consider it is the word of God, and nothing should be changed with it. I want to say why the Arabic language will not die. For one reason, because it's the language of the Quran. The other thing, which is also the main reason, it's a root-based language. That means that root, based on that root, based on kataba, is the root, kataba, to write. Okay, you'll go on so many words. You could go on so many words. So that's why we'll never die, based on the root system. All the Semitic language based on the root system, they will never die. Some of them die, but the rebirth happened for political reasons, like the Hebrew. The Hebrew was a dying language, just because the establishment of Israel in 1948 came back. Otherwise, there's no Hebrew language. Any other?
I teach high school, Arabic, level 1 and level 2. For level 1, for beginners, I use the shapes of the letter. For example, I teach them set. First week, I teach the set of the letters that have the U shape.
Yeah.
Like noon, saad, dad. They know when they connect the same way. Other day, I teach the tail letter or the boat shape letter. So yeah. This helps the student.